Welcome students to the online class. We will see the explanation of lesson number 4. Albert Einstein at school. Patrick Pringle. Now this lesson describes about the early childhood and education of one of the famous scientists, Albert Einstein. It gives the description about his school life, how Albert Einstein studied, what were his subjects in which he had keen interest. Moreover, it describes about his habit and mentality regarding education, schooling, and learning and teaching process. Let's move on to the explanation. Albert Einstein was one of the greatest scientists. This lesson describes how he has expelled from a German school. This lesson explains about one incident that happened in the life of Albert Einstein when he was studying in a school in Germany. He was expelled from that school. He did not like going to that school. He himself wanted to get rid of this school. But before his plan worked out, he was expelled by the school authorities. Now the lesson mentions about the history teacher, Mr. Brown, who asked Einstein in which year the Prussians defeated the French at the Battle of Waterloo. This was a very general question. Being a history teacher, he taught about the Battle of Waterloo and finally asked a simple question to Albert Einstein. He asked in which year did this battle take place. Einstein, he stood up and replied that he didn't know the answer. The history teacher asked why he did not know when he had been told often enough. This is a very, common thing that happens in the classroom. Whenever teacher teach the student, he asked certain questions as to know whether the students are getting his point or getting his subject or not. So similarly, here the history teacher of Albert Einstein, he asked the year of the Battle of Waterloo. And he stood up. Instead of answering politely, he rudely says that he does not know the answer. The another question is asked by the history teacher, that oftentimes he taught about the battle, oftentimes he was taught by the teacher, then how come he did not know the answer? At this question, Einstein again replied that he must have forgotten. The teacher, Mr. Brown, asked him if he had ever tried to learn. Now, this is the argument. The history teacher asked the question. Albert Einstein strikes in argument with the history teacher and he says that I must have forgotten the answer. At this point, the history teacher asked whether he tried to learn anything. Ever he tried to learn? Einstein replied that he had not. That is so simple. He is giving the answer rudely and arrogantly, and moreover directly he said no. The history teacher asked him the reason for not doing so. Then another question, A series of questions has been asked by the history teacher. Another question, why didn't you learn? At this point, Einstein replied that he couldn't see any point in learning dates. That is a manner of explanation. Why he don't learn? It's because he couldn't find any point, in learning the dates, any importance in learning the dates of the battle. If one could want to find the dates of the battle, better he can look into the book and find the dates of the battle. So there is no need of learning the dates. The history teacher was speechless for a moment. He failed to utter anything. He does not had any words to respond to such an answer from Albert Einstein. He asked Albert that it meant that he didn't believe in education at all. If the pattern of education is not followed by the student, that means they do not believe in the system of education. So another question raised by the history teacher that said that Albert Einstein did not believe in the education at all. Albert replied that he did, but according to him, learning facts was not education. He was interested in ideas, not in facts. Now, concept of education, here introduced by Albert Einstein, he is saying that there is no point of learning the facts. There is no importance of learning the facts. Learning the facts is not a system of education. But he says that knowing the new ideas, learning the new ideas. So he says that, in other words, education means innovative ideas. Education means implementing new ideas more than facts. He was interested in ideas, not in facts. The teacher didn't like all this argument. The teacher, he did not like this type of argument. He said that Albert was a disgrace to the school. Now, when he had nothing to say, he says that Albert is a disgrace to the school and that he shouldn't continue to come to the school. Now, that this is a kind of remark that that was given by a history teacher. Albert felt miserable that day when he left the school. He only wished that his father would take him away from the school. Now, when he was scolded by, or when he was remarked by the history teacher regarding his school coming, he was disappointed. He felt miserable. Since that day, he did not want to go to that school. He only wished that his father could come and take him away from the school. But his father would like him to stay in the school till he had taken his diploma. But father, he knew that father would not permit him, or father will not come and take him away from the school until he gets the degree of diploma. His father didn't have enough money. His father did not have money. So Albert had to rent a room in one of the poorest localities of Munich. Now see here, his father was poor. He did not have money. So Albert was forced to live in the poorest localities of Munich. Albert hated the atmosphere of the slum area. This area is slum area. People, uncivilized, uneducated, they lived in this area. His landlady beat his children regularly. Now, the people, their moral standard is also very low. They believe in beating, fighting, and they did not had
any moral standard.
Such a locality was where Albert lived. Albert told his friend Yuri that he will never pass the examination from the school. Albert told his friend Yuri that he is not going to get passed in the examination, nor he is going to get the degree of diploma. He also told his cousin Elsa the same next time she came to Munich, but she was sure that he would pass the exam. Now, Albert knew that in this way, if he is going to, he is not going to pass the examination, nor he is going to get the degree of diploma. He shared this to two people. One is his friend, one is his cousin Elsa. But Elsa thought differently about Albert. She says that she is sure that Albert would pass in the examination. She knew so many boys who were very stupid than Albert, yet they passed the examination. Now, the concept here she introduced to Albert is rote learning. She came across many students, many boys who were more stupid and foolish than Albert Einstein, but they passed in the examination. They recited the questions, answers, and all those things just like a parrot. And thus they appeared in the examination and they were passed. So this cousin Elsa, she gave an advice to Albert Einstein that if he also recite or learn or rote learning, if he adopt the technique of rote learning, he will be able to pass. It's so easy to memorize the answers and then just write it down in the paper. In this way, Albert would be passed. Even if you don't understand anything, you can still recite or memorize just like a parrot. Now, Albert said that how could that be? Albert felt doubtful that how it is that one can learn the thing, one can memorize the thing without understanding it thoroughly. He failed to understand this technique of rote learning. Albert was in fact interested in books on science and music. Now, see here, Albert liked science, music. He played violin. When he was in the age of 6, he started playing violin until his landlady asked him to stop. He lived in a rental building. He played the violin and the landlady did not like violin. So he stopped playing violin. Albert was disgusted with the place. He told his friend Yuri that he wanted to get away from that place. Yuri asked him what he would do then. Albert said that he didn't know. Albert wanted to escape from that slum area, from that place where he lived. But Yuri asked another question. What would you do when you will go from this place? Where you will go? And he answers simply, I don't know. That means he doesn't know from where or from here where he will go. And thus he replied directly to Yuri. Suddenly, something struck in his mind. He wanted to get rid of Munich. He wanted to get rid of the school. Suddenly, something struck in his mind. He asked Yuri if he knew a friendly doctor who could issue him a medical certificate for nervous breakdown. Now this is something that he planned. This is something that came into his mind. If he could be issued a certificate that stated that Albert is not physically fit, mentally fit, he is suffering from nervous breakdown or depression, he is not fit enough to go to the school, it is not proper for him to go to the school, thus he can escape from the school. This would enable him to leave the school when Yuri came next. He told Albert that he had fixed an appointment for him with the doctor for the next day. Yuri, being a good and faithful friend of Albert, he knew many medical students who had just become doctors. They have started their medical practice. So she found some of his friends. She found a doctor from one of his friends who was his friend and told him all the things about Albert. And when the next time when Yuri came to Albert and informed him that he found a doctor who was his friend, the doctor was Ernest Wayne, and he specialized in nerves. The name of the doctor is Ernest Wayne, who just now started his medical practice. Albert, he wanted to work according to his plan. What was his plan? To get a certificate, and that certificate will be presented before the principal. Thus, the principal would grant him leave, and thus he will be able to get rid of this school. Albert spent the next day wondering what to tell the doctor. Now, Albert knew that he did not suffer from any depression or nervous breakdown. He had to pretend. So all the day he wondered what to tell doctor and how to tell doctor. When the time came for the appointment, he was really nervous. When he met the doctor, the latter told him that Yuri had told him everything. Now see here, Yuri had already mentioned about each and everything regarding Albert to this doctor, Ernest Well. So Albert, when he tried to pretend, the doctor says that everything is disclosed to him. Everything was told to him by Yuri, Albert's friend. The doctor asked him if he certified that he had a nervous breakdown, what he would do. There is one more question raised by the doctor. He says that if he will issue a certificate of nervous breakdown, then what he will do? Albert replied that he would go to Italy and get admission in an Italian college or institute. But the doctor asked him how he could get an admission without a diploma. That is a natural question. If you haven't passed the examination of diploma, how you are going to get admission in the college? If you will not pass in the 12th examination, how you will be able to get admission in the college? So he said that, Albert said that he would ask his mathematics teacher to give him something about his work. In other words, he's saying that his favorite teacher, maths teacher, would provide him a recommendation letter on the basis of which he will be able to get the admission in the college. That will be enough for him to get an admission in Italy. Finally, the doctor gave him a certificate so that he could stay away from the school for 6 months. Here, one important thing is that before the doctor issued him a certificate,
he stated that Albert indeed was suffering with depression or nervous breakdown. If he would have not been suffering by nervous breakdown, he would have never come to the doctor. Saying this, he issued the certificate to Albert by which he can get 6 months leave from the school. He can stay away from the school for 6 months. Then after, Albert informed Yuri that he would take the certificate to the head teacher the next day. Next day, Albert had gone to the school. He made a plan that he will produce this certificate of nervous breakdown before the head teacher, before the principal. And thus, he went to the school. The mathematics teacher, Mr. Coach, gave him the reference he wanted. Then the head teacher summoned him to his office as he was sitting in the classroom. As he was thinking that today he will submit his certificate of nervous breakdown and he will get leave for 6 months. At that time, he was called to the office of the head teacher. He didn't know why he had been sent for. Albert startled. Albert wondered why he had been called to the office of the head teacher. Perhaps he was to be punished for the bad work and laziness, as usual. Albert was punished by the teacher most often for his laziness, for his arrogance and rude behavior. So this time he thought that he might have been called to the office so that he could receive any punishment for his laziness, arrogance and bad work. But the head teacher told him that he was not prepared to have him in the school. He taking that certificate, he went to the office of the head teacher. And as he stood before the head teacher made a statement. He let know Albert that he is not prepared anymore to have Albert in the school any longer. That means the principal wanted to expel Albert Einstein from the school. No longer he want to accommodate, no longer he want to have Albert in the school. Now he gave reason, two reasons. First, because in the presence of Albert Einstein, a teacher cannot teach. Point number one, reason number one, why he wanted to expel Albert from the school, it is that no one can teach in the presence of Albert. He is such a nuisance creator. He just disturbed the class and the teachers. Point number two, reason number two, that in his presence, no teaching and learning activities can be carried out. The other students also will not be able to study in the presence of Albert. He wanted Einstein to leave the school. He should leave the school on his own. Otherwise, he would be expelled. Now there is a chance that is given by the principal, the head teacher. Head teacher asked Albert to leave the school by his own. That means he is free to leave the school. Or else the head teacher would expel him from the school. His presence made it impossible for the teacher to teach and students to learn. This is the excuse. This is the reason that is stated by the head teacher, that his presence made it impossible for the teacher to teach and the student to learn. Without saying anything, he walked out. Albert left school where he had spent 5 miserable years. He didn't give it even a last look. Now see here, he felt as if the certificate in his pockets were burning. Burning, that means now he do not need those certificates anymore. He had no need to produce it before the head teacher. All his plan seemed to be failed. All his plans were failed, but result is expected by Albert. Result is in the favor of Albert. He himself wanted to leave the school. Now the headmaster gave the chance to Albert to leave the school. What he expected, that thing happened, but not by the certificates that he have obtained from the doctor, but by the medium of the head teacher. And when he was going from the school, he did not look back where he had spent 5 years, 5 miserable years. He had hated the town as much as he hated the school. He lived in Munich and he hated that place. He hated the school. And Yuri was the only friend of Albert in the entire Munich. Yuri wished him good luck before his departure. He thought he would be happier at the place where he was going. Now, in order to say goodbye to Yuri, he had been to him. And Yuri wished him goodbye and good luck. And he thought that he would be happy in the place where he was going to. This is the childhood experience of Albert. This is the one of the school incident of Albert, where he wanted to get rid of the school. He planned and devised everything that he will escape from the school by producing a certificate of nervous breakdown. But before his plan worked out, he was expelled from the school on his own. He was allowed to leave the school due to 2 reasons. One, the teacher cannot teach in his presence, nor the students can learn. This is how the Albert was able to escape from the school and escape from the miserable place where he had spent almost 5 years of his life.